Hey guys, welcome to our Game of Thrones, a Telltale Game series, episode 1. I hope you enjoy this video as much as I enjoyed making and playing through this game. And remember to vote thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment. I'd love to hear from you guys, and enjoy.
It's funny
if you like the reactions. Alright, fine. We'll play with a cam. Mr. Sexy Beard Man, huh?
Other nickname, I'm gonna learn how to
actually, we're gonna delete this guy. We just played a little bit earlier to make sure that it fit on the thing, and we'll start fresh right now. The Northerners will never forget. Begin episode 1. Actually, I probably should put that. First play, episode 1. I sent tweets, put it on Facebook, put it in the Discord, we're good to go. Let's make sure chat's open, and we'll begin episode 1. MM is here with us, and she is going to be making cookies tonight. So excited. Went food shopping today.
That looks like Tyrion, and he's dirty.
Yes, it was Tyrion.
Who's here?
Nobody's here yet. For thousands of years, House Forrester has been loyal bannermen to House Stark. In the darkest reaches of the Wolfswood, they harvest the rare ironwood trees. Now the North has been ripped apart by war, and rival houses seek to claim Forrester ironwood for themselves, and the fate of Forrester hangs in the balance. Alright. Walder Frey. It seems a lot louder when I tried it earlier.
Kingslayer, Oathbreaker,
brought to
his knees by the men of the North,
and set free by the women. You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Old Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
Bloody sword.
Make sure it's spotless this time. Old Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it.
All right, cleaning the sword.
Now that is a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself someday.
You? I'll never have a sword like that. I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest.
Why not?
They don't give swords like that to pig farms.
Limited amount of time to make a choice.
I had Andy, okay. You know.
Hand him what?
Capturing him.
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk, he barely made it out of his tent.
Shh! Let him finish.
Oh, he'll talk all night if you let him.
You captured the Kingslayer?
Aye. Well, I'd have handed it.
Aye. And round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What did I tell you?
I brought him to his knees.
Lord Forrester.
Not before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face.
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
I'm questioning Norrin's story. This grows more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get your liege lord some wine.
Go on. Right, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it.
Okay.
Norrin's family has faithfully served
House
Forrester
for
centuries. His honor is beyond reproach. House Tully is forever in his debt. They've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield.
Okay.
Fetch your coat. Tonight we celebrate.
The art's different. It's almost like a painted style. It's kind of cool.
To Robb Stark, the King in the North!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard!
The gods have favored us!
Sorry, you're not watching?
Onward to Casterly Rock!
Death to the Lannisters!
Iron from ice!
Iron from ice. Yep, sorry.
Got it.
One of those games, I guess. You click off the screen and it derps up.
I need you to keep an eye out for Roderick.
As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become. On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
Is also the question.
So we're gonna meet some more dudes.
What's to be done with you?
More characters.
It's been on my mind for a while now.
With me, my lord?
With me, my
You've
lord.
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever. How shall I reward your loyalty? What can I offer you?
To bring honor to House Forrester, my lord.
You have more honor than those who were born to it.
There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire.
I guess it's a good thing when somebody remembers something.
It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett. Your hard work has paid off.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go, and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
This is different.
Bloody hell. Empty. Squire! Fetch us more wine!
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Can I get up to you?
Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you.
So?
I outrank you. You should help me.
What an asshole thing to say. I mean, we say, yeah, no problem, we're gonna help you. And he's like, yeah, we outrank you, you have to.
Bruh. Push more wine, rub my armor, clean my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norin while you serve the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for once.
You'd better watch your tongue, Owen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin.
See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms. I suppose this beats pig farming.
Who doesn't love
Who
bacon?
Who doesn't love bacon?
Ah, pig farmers. All I'm saying
is... This guy is always insulting.
At this rate, we'll never be more than this. Which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life. All in wine around a fucking wedding.
Give it time. You'll get there.
More easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were Castellan at House Forrester, I'd feel different.
Chat's
Who
working.
My uncle is, that's nothing to do with it.
Hello, bot.
How much further?
It's right over there.
Oh, we're at the Twins.
Take your time. You lot have drunk your share. Good thing Lord Walders. In a generous mood. Fucking phrase. Nice night for a wedding.
Everybody's armed.
Not often he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Oh, we're at the Red Wedding.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Garrett. What? What's wrong?
Yep.
What's gone into you?
What's happening?
You're acting rather odd.
We have enough wine.
And take the fucking flagon already.
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Owen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush.
We have to go.
But what about... What the hell was that about? Slow down, would you?
Run!
Back to camp!
Oh.
quick time events.
Garrett, we have to get back.
Get from the king.
Ready, boys!
Uh-oh.
Whoa! Shoot that one! What?
Oh, I got that. I didn't understand what he's asking me to do.
Nothing I could do.
Uh-oh.
Find
I think it's the sun.
Quickly!
Yes, it's a sword. Or not. Okay, I don't get a sword. And he gets an arrow.
You fucking traitor! Go, my lord, while there's still time!
Oh, he's fucked up.
Seven hells.
We have to keep moving, my lord.
I'd never make it. They'll hunt us down like dogs.
While the prince says time's over,
well, yeah, he's bleeding pretty good.
Guard this with your life. Return it to Ironrath, where it belongs. There's no time to wait.
Johnny Breezy, 6879. Thank you for the host, buddy. How goes it?
You have to
welcome,
go.
Welcome.
You're welcome to the fucking torch.
I won't leave you, my lord. Can't.
And you will,
my lord.
Hey, John.
You will obey me. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove.
Yeah, we just fired up.
Must never be lost. Tell no
the
one
North
but
Grove
him.
Do you must understand? Never be lost.
You must swear.
Okay.
Tell only your uncle Duncan.
The North Grove, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters.
Uncle. On your honor, you must
nice.
Do
nice, we're streaming tonight.
House. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
With love, John Frey.
Fire Emblem. Oh, awesome. Oh, cool. Look at this thing. We have like the whole entrance sequence too. Oh, shit. It looks much cooler in the game than it does even on the TV show. Dude.
What are you chewing?
Me and Cherry, we're having a conversation. Forester lands, the King's Road. Hey, Cherry. How's you doing, buddy? Oh, pig. They called him a pig farmer. Kitty's in the box.
Yeah. What are you doing,
you
guy?
Blood.
Well, first she has to rip up the cardboard. And then stuff.
Why is there blood on the ground?
Fresh.
A dead pig. Playing investigators now. There's blood and a pig and fire? Smoke over there? There's a wagon. It's an overturned cart, so somebody rob some sort of pig farmer.
That's father's car.
His father's pigs?
Lord Bolton better give us fucking titles for this.
Winter may be coming, but at least still have his bacon.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father.
I said move on. I recognize you. You're a forester, squire.
Former stock bannermen have no claim on land anymore. Or haven't you heard?
The Starks are dead.
Where'd you get that sword? Not a chance that sword is his. Must have stolen it. Out here by himself. Probably a deserter.
None of your fucking business. We're gonna feed you to the fucking pigs.
That sword's too big for you, boy. You can barely pick it up.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy.
Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North. I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
No.
I'll have that sword, boy. Fuck you.
Finish this fucking pig farmer. Pathetic. You really are a pig farmer.
Oh, shit. Check on your dad. There you go.
Father?
Oh. Gary. He's all stabbed up.
You survived.
No good.
Your sister. She hid.
Oh no, they killed her too.
I tried to stop them.
Up and dead. That's a really weird aesthetic to the art quality.
I'll kill the man who did this.
It's kind of like painted. It's really cool. Different. Iron Wrath, stronghold of House Forrester. Kind of a cool castle.
It's Garrett! Get the Castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
Garrett!
I was too late. They were already dead.
Bring the Maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
Oh.
Two White Hill soldiers
and a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what? My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable, unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
Blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg. Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
They attacked me. I had no choice but to defend myself.
Of course. And we can't let the Whitehills just walk all over us. These maggots ought to help prevent infection.
Maggots. Oh.
Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Ooh, look at that thing.
It's a dark days, I fear. To lose the lord of the house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal.
Do you see the maggots yet?
Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this.
Maggots are
the late Lord
over.
Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Well, what do we do
oh,
now?
I see it on the
future of this house.
I see it on my other
Eastern
screen.
Hands now, although he is young.
What's up, Genie?
Prepared to lead.
Tuning in just in time for the maggots, I guess.
Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
What's going on, buddy?
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, a squire, and not his son, Roger.
The hell?
Because he tuned it in to see...
Not that maggots. Handled himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
That's not how it happened. Roderick had already fallen.
Hmm. Well, I'd imagine...
Hold these maggots, please.
...would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg. Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
Alright, we're gonna get some bandages for ourselves. Oh, I almost forgot. What'd you forget? Oh, Genie with his hey guys. Marilyn.
Oh, hey!
The
sorry,
hey guys.
I couldn't look at the screen.
This might help.
How you doing, Genie? How was your day? That was a lot of fun last night. Oh, look at the bucket full of maggots. This guy's weird. It's better to let maggots swim around in your leg.
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
I guess.
And he's calling them cute. Look at the cute little maggots. Okay, no more maggots.
You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
I'm fine, Maester Otengwin. Look, I'll show you. The Ironwood Grove.
Watch the Cavs parade today. Nice. Did LeBron cry? Again? The Lord's Chair. Can I walk behind it? No. So we have bandages, we have herbs, and we have a sword.
Oh, that's kind of far.
60 minutes northeast. Oh, okay. He dropped a couple F-bombs on live TV. Awesome.
Asher. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately.
Exiled.
Those people do not have experience.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now.
It's a lot of work.
Mira. Still in King's Landing, I suppose. Although,
Mira's in King's Landing, Asher's in Essos.
Lady Forrester. She's always been kind to me.
1.3 million people.
Myself.
I've been to two Bruins parades, all the Patriots parades, and
Lord
I think
Forrester.
Two of the Red Sox parades.
It was an honor to squire
the
for
the
it.
The first Cavs one that was 9 degrees.
Gregor the Good.
Yes.
They're crazy.
No.
Roderick. He was our best warrior by far.
I don't even really like parades.
I like our sports teams, so...
Yeah.
Worth?
I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it. Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you.
So, 5 hours long, huh? 30 floats.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine.
That
I need time to tell, but...
Like, so
Lady
big,
Forrest.
Like
welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what
Talia.
Happened. Is it true? Your family... I'm so sorry.
Later.
Aww.
Off to bed now. Hurry on. Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He was a hero, my lady. The bravest man on the battlefield by far.
Yet he was unable to save his own son.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion.
He
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us.
So I'm working on an idea for next Tuesday. Might need some help. Some voice acting.
Okay. I was told you were the last to see my husband.
Well, Marilyn will be happy to help you with any voice acting you need.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask...
She has headphones in.
Was there anything he said?
Whatever you need, Jamie, I got you, bud.
Before he passed, he asked me to return this to House Forrester. He said this is where it belongs.
Oh, no. I avoided her question. That's not what I meant to do.
Of course. My lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure.
Let me know what you're thinking of, Jamie.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Fuck that dude.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much, I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
If not now, when?
A small audio clip I want to make and want a few lines read.
Ramsay Snow will be here within a week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us
fuck that guy and his bloody dogs.
While they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So, what's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this will accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
It wasn't murder. It was justice.
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take. Which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay?
You can't send me away.
We have no choice, Garrett.
Where would you have the boy go?
The one place that's safe, beyond the reach of the Boltons.
Send him to the wall.
You're sending him to the wall? The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution.
I'll do what's best for the house. So I'll go. I'm not afraid.
I know it doesn't seem fair.
Leave Garrett alone!
That settles it, then.
What's in the box, Kitty?
You can have
what's in the box?
And I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
I hope you didn't get my laundry in that shot. Hey, what's up, Killer Bags? Good to see you, buddy.
Well, I could try and move over there and take a closer picture, but...
Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance.
How you doing, Killer?
And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war.
He promoted me. Met the twins. We were to ride in the van to Casterly Rock and...
Just need some people side, to ride lines, read lines for an audio.
It was well deserved, okay. Garrett. You worked hard.
Yes, give me a script of what you want me to do.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What? What is it?
Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message.
Kid got you sick? Oh man, sorry, dude.
The North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry.
You caught me by
surprise.
Sorry,
not feeling good, man.
It's not often discussed, if ever.
Where is the North Grove?
That I cannot say. Not yet, at least. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
So we're probably going to meet Jon Snow.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll serve with honor.
I know you will.
Yeah, man, I feel better, dude.
Garrett, wait!
Oh, it's the little lady. Talia's necklace.
Be safe.
Little bundles of germs. That's the old saying, right? Come home with to your little bundle of germ. I am pure juice. Welcome to the stream, man. Thanks for that follow. I don't know, Killa. I only started it. We've been playing for like a half hour. It's kind of story driven. It seems pretty cool.
Hey, what's up, Juice?
I am pure juice. Yeah, so this is the new lord. Saha, dude, it's Pure Juice from Twitter. Well, welcome, dude.
I couldn't find him. Could you?
Good to have you.
Pure Juice from Twitter.
Pure Juice from Twitter.
He hides too well. Juicy
Juice.
He would reveal himself. I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. Oi, miss. What's up, Duck 5800? Oh, shit. I didn't do the thing.
Ryan, look who we've found.
Don't worry. It's just a game.
Oh my god, McMuffin.
I don't like it.
Nice.
He was worried you were gone. I thought
we'd
never find you again.
Welcome back.
I'm right here.
Mates, what's up, Duck?
I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asher. And
do the thing. We're trying to do the thing.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and
can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Trying to do
Ryan,
the thing.
She's
do that thing.
Safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett
Duck
to
Duck
die
Goose.
Either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to
Who's
the war.
Who's the goose?
I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
Garrett is smart.
No one will tell
he's
me
wicked
what
smart.
Did,
my boy here,
he
he's wicked
serious.
Smart.
I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland
hey,
talking.
Hey, Nate.
They said
someone told me to follow you? Who told you that?
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who told you
said
that,
they're
Duck?
Worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one.
Welcome,
he says
Nate.
He can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
I don't care what he says.
Really
I can protect you.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Who told you to follow,
Ethan,
Duck?
You should let Sir Roy
teach
you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Oh, cool, Nate. Still doing the Eve?
Do you remember when we were younger? And we all used to play here.
That's
you,
my boy.
Roderick,
Asher.
Milksop.
We'd all be out here for hours.
Danielle, you're a milksop.
Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun.
Awesome movie.
But then, then everything changed.
Fall back, guys. Let's watch this
Roderick
movie together.
Became so serious. The Lord in training. He never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way
you
are.
Hey, Game of Thrones fans, guys. Who's hyped for the season finale?
I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I don't want to get angry, but I may have to. Father did sometimes.
But you're nice. Everybody says that about you.
Vanilla Ice did a concert in my city a couple months ago. Okay.
Since you're the new lord, you can do
very dedicated
you want,
to
Eve. I suppose.
Okay, cool.
Everyone will have to
I'm
do
glad you enjoy it.
So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly,
I feel like I'm watching a depressing version of Shell or something. What do you mean?
Shell?
Shell what? S-H-E-L.
I don't know what Shell is.
I'm not sure what he means either.
What's the matter?
Lord
Shrek.
Whitehill has arrived.
Okay.
And certainly unexpected.
This is Game of Thrones, though.
Can't he meet with
Why
Duncan?
Would Shrek and autocorrect to Shrell?
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were the Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well.
Game of Bones. You're all about that, Danielle. Boned up. For real, though. Fat thumbs. That fat finger, though. Never had a girl complain.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why...
Get hashtag get boned?
I told him.
Oh, no.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, You're making was, it happen, Danielle.
No
it's, gonna, it's trending
the
now.
The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction.
Hashtag getting boned.
Firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got five times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men know.
Rimshot. Yes. You know it. All about that rimshot. Look at this douchebag. Don't give him any satisfaction? Well, why not?
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house.
Thank you, Lord Whitehill.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Forresters finally get their due. Aye. Hold your tongue, you coward. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt?
Everybody get your bone on.
Bloody amateur. No courtesies.
Fetch Lord Whitehill some bread and salt. It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roos Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for five fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
What is it you want? Oh, pure juice. I was going to put that that sound effect up for as a
your
command
man,
today.
Squire, we were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said. When
he
your
eats
man
shit for breakfast?
For no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
That's not how it happened.
And you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the lord of this house.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me! Who's the one who did it?
Duncan. The Castellan sent him.
And you call yourself a lord? You're no lord. You're a fucking puppet. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
There we go.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this...
Oh, now he wants to be nice.
This is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton
someone
will
kill
have
that
the final
prick already.
Say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester
I don't know
man
if his hands
killed
out
one
his pants.
Of his own. That the new what? Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my
that.
Justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
All right, so we just pissed this dude off. Money's on the redhead. The hell?
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
Mira in King's Landing.
Although just a handmaiden, she has Margaery Tyrell's favor. And
Mira Forrester,
worth
the Red
to
Keep.
The king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay, if it's presented to her as it should be.
So she works for Margaery.
It almost sounds like I have a mic then.
Alright, what's in the box? What's in the box? We need to know. What's in the box? Show me. Illuminati. Did Illuminati right here.
Asher sent me this coin to remember.
Oh, there was a pyramid on it a second ago.
What a strange place, Essos.
I want to hear MM sing. Heartbroken.
Oh my god,
aww.
No. No, you don't.
Heart's
very
broken.
Kind of Lady Margaery to give this to
give
me.
Give me some other dares. I'll probably
it once belonged
that.
To Lady Elena.
Okay. We got a
Ethan
book.
Made this for me.
Oh no, it's just a tree. All the reminders of home. Oh, and a note. Read.
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Margaery has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss
yeah,
all of
same
you.
Your dad
and
all.
I look forward to the day you can.
And now he's dead. Womp, womp, womp. Okay, what else can we do? Oh, looking at a dusty old tome.
Wonders Made by Man by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick.
What else
I
we got?
I hope to see them all someday.
Well, let's look out the window.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
She sounds homesick. Yeah, since her family's pretty much dead.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Okay. The little lord's gonna die. They seem salty as fuck. Pure Juice, thanks for hanging out. Alright, I'm coming. I don't know how to move. Open the door. I want to hear MM sing too.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
He's putting rocks in. Oh, is that like
begging
coal?
Your pardon, m'lady, but you
looks
right.
Like a brazier.
If you don't
that's a dirty
ask,
boy.
You seem rather upset.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
Notice your honesty.
Kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
He's a very grown-up voice for being, like, a little kid.
You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends.
That's a
dirty boy. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei? Uh-oh.
Talking to Cersei.
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but...
Why are you telling me this?
Someone please watch this child and feed him a sandwich.
House Forrester.
He is quite dirty.
He is.
He's like to know.
Transporting coal.
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble.
He is pretty dirty.
Most
look at his
people
elbow.
Don't tend to notice a coal boy. Not in King's Landing with so
oh,
many
he's
lords
a coal
and ladies.
Boy.
You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Danielle wants to give him a sandwich. Oh, Marjorie.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
She doesn't look as hot as in the show.
Time for us to talk.
Oh, but it's actually her.
Something we must discuss.
She's actually... It's her, the... Whatever the girl's name who plays Natalie Dormer.
From the day you arrived in Highgarden,
that's actually her voice. That's cool.
A friend than as my handmaiden, a dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain.
Well, they got all the actors to do the voice acting. That'd be cool.
What you've suffered is beyond imagining.
I need your help, my lady.
Of course, and I will help you in any way I can. But there's
her dress isn't as revealing. I know. Kind of sucks.
You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept.
Shuts
she
up as the King's Guard goes by.
My service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort. For what, I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
Okay. So we're
See
gonna
if the
lie.
Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Fuck Cersei and her bitch ass. Danielle.
You'll be fine.
No, Danielle's saying just fuck
you
her.
May feel one thing.
Spoiler, she gets married to the king. Oh no, you ruined it. Can't play the game now.
Good luck.
That wasn't a very cool look. That wasn't the mountain, was it? The mountain was in Kingsguard. Until he turns zombie mountain. Marjorie looks weird.
Weird, like computery, like her face looks too.
You can do this.
She looks like an alien.
Yeah, it's kind of odd. You can tell that it's trying to be her, but it's not her.
Oh, look, Tyrion's on the other chair.
Ah, Lady Tyrion. Marjorie, aren't you looking?
Oh, it's actually
lovely.
Tyrion's voice.
Lord Tyrion.
Peter Dinklage.
Your Grace?
Squinty blinks are weird.
With your permission, allow me
to
introduce.
Wow, Cersei looks exactly
Lady
like Cersei.
House Forrester.
Where's Cersei?
They'll be there in like 10 seconds.
Your Grace.
Queen
Girl
is pleased.
Knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
Cersei's pretty good.
Pre-Joffrey's death.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Think so, yeah. This is right after the Red Wedding.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Is my family loyal to the king?
The new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
Hmm. And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
Yes, Your Grace. They are traitors.
The Starks were your liege lord, yet you name them traitors so easily. I take it this is the kind of loyalty the king can expect from you, if you have any loyalty at all.
Wow,
is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey, if it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned, but now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester
can you just kill a bitch?
Does seem rather unique.
To our mutual benefit, Your Grace.
And at the pleasure of your king. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
Oh, I didn't mean to accidentally misspell the word.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Marjorie here was betrothed to Rhaenyra Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one
She's
day
a bitch
rule
morning,
the
noon, and night. So yeah. Calm and cool at the same time.
Can we fault her
like
for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
You gotta win now. I'm the queen.
I won't
of
judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves. pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Marjorie. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question.
After the Blackwater?
And if your loyalties were to become conflicted
Tyrion's
between your king and
wrecked.
The very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
Let
would...
Let the girl answer the question.
I would be true to the king, your grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
Thank you, Tyrion.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
We want to talk to Tyrion. We don't want to talk to Cersei.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton.
We only spoke briefly,
but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss.
These are trying times, my lord. My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the north.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood.
You can help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although, what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
Uh-oh.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you?
We should get a direwolf.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival.
I hope we meet again.
Sansa and Tyrion.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Okay. As cute as they are, I'm so done with wolves.
Mira. I was worried. How was it?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. I'd rather not discuss it, if you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible. But at least it's over
Why
now.
Why don't you like wolves, Dan?
Wait, I don't know how old Dan is.
Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah?
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour.
Put it back.
We're just having a bit of fun.
I don't like this girl.
It's probably for the best. I've heard he's a bit perverse. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king,
I can only imagine what that would be.
A friend
like.
Of mine owns two wolf dogs. They're far more work than I ever thought, and you have to constantly make sure they know
would
their place. They're
Joffrey
quick to try and dominate.
If it meant you'd become queen. He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
Oh.
Let's see.
She's a douchebag.
Who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
Once you are queen, the lords and ladies will do their best to please you.
You learn very quickly. You were brave agreeing to obey the Boltons. That cannot have been easy. I know you must fear what Lord Bolton might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Cyra. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust
her. I want to send Cyra away.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
I wouldn't have asked her. Nope. I don't care about this Sarah chick.
Go on.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought... if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
She did mention earlier that she has to be careful.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady.
What she says and does.
And I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise, but my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks. And now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
I will forever be in your debt. My family will forever be in your debt.
Ramsay Bolton is a dick. He's still Ramsay Snow.
I don't know, Mira.
So that's even more of a spoiler alert, Genie.
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Wait, what?
She's very behind in the show.
Very well.
Jesus,
I'll
I'm behind.
Request, but I cannot promise anything.
How far behind?
Thank you, my lady.
Just
I will send a raven to my family at once.
She's gonna screw us over so bad. Marjorie didn't tell us anything. Time me out quick. Time me out, purge my chat.
What?
Purge.
Did you want a duel? Oh, that's fine.
Oh. That's loud. That horse scared
me. Seven L's.
Seven L's. I can click on your chat. Don't, Danielle. Don't. Oh, no.
Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Yeah, it's very similar to his voice. I think it's right.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father.
The edges around the screen are turning red.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What is that?
It cracked a twig.
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There.
You heard
hear
the
that?
Horse. Is that Theon? No,
something.
It's... Let's hang out. Oh no, oh no, oh no, why did we do this? We should have ran.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
A naked man holds few secrets. A flayed man holds none. They just flayed this dude right on the road. Oh,
what
shit.
The hell?
Okay, go make cookies. Okay, it's been 5 minutes. Go make cookies. Why are you laughing at me?
You have
Lord
to eat
Ethan!
I like cookies.
As I was saying, you are young.
Hey, I like
there are those
cookies.
Within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you.
I don't remember him in Misfits. I don't remember Misfits, actually. I don't know if I've seen it.
Your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the River Valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good.
Gregor the Good.
He was fair and wise.
And what would they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Lord Sentinel.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move! Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
Uh-oh.
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Oh,
Lord Ethan. Smith.
Why did you kick this man?
This Craven is a deserter and a thief.
These be your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. Seize five people.
We all fucking know it!
All five.
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roiland said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks
He's
true.
Right.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy. Go. Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
Then you admit to the crime, in front of all gathered here.
I am only what this house made me. You cannot expect a man to live on loyalty alone.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it
is. Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief.
We can send him to the wall.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us. Make him pay for what he's given us justice.
Fuck him.
I will decide.
Send him to the wall.
Leave the poor man
Take
alone.
His fingers.
He's a thief.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man.
No, I wouldn't be punishing an innocent man. You stole.
Please, my lord. My family depends on
you. Alright, guys. Wall or fingers? This one's not timed. Help me out. I'm leaning towards fingers. Fingers. Danielle wants to take three fingers. Marilyn?
Sounds good.
Alright, we got two. We got three for three fingers, so we're gonna take some fingers. Wall, C.W. Donahue, what's up? Stop being a dick? No, I'm not
Ethan
a dick.
House Forrester, Lord of Iron
Fuck Rust, you, Genie.
We're
taking his fingers.
Oh, please, my lord.
Your house is doomed anyhow.
My lord,
right?
Please.
He already said that.
My lord, normally it is the lord's duty to carry out the sentence.
I'm cut.
I am willing to
I will
carry
do
it.
I will carry out the sentence.
Oh no, I'm really gonna cut off this dude's fingers. Oh! Good aim! Cookies. I like cookies.
It's time for you to make cookies.
Hey, I like cookies. Did you say cookies? I really like cookies. I'm sorry, I was busy cutting some dude's hand off.
Was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must meet
out. Bruh, if you miss, you fuck up this fapping hand. I know,
just
right?
Yourself, of course.
It's a lord's duty, so I did it.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side.
Stop being a dick.
Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here. The Bracer of the Sentinel. The Badge
Harry,
of
no.
Office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choice as sentinel.
Come off to the kitchen.
Thank you, MM.
Can't
council,
wait for cookie
lord.
Dough.
Well, there's not
going to
be a lot left, but a lot of horses getting sent away.
But I like cookies.
What?
But I like cookies.
We'll maybe have like one.
There's only two choices. Alright, let's talk to the guys, see what they say. That's the Meister. Oh, look at the food. I want some food.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
Eric said people were going to starve. Why can't we feed them?
The war has taken its toll. Mm. Even our own stores for the house are dwindling. We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
I trust you to make the right decision.
We'll have to take food from the small folk and hope they can fend for themselves. If the house falls, they'd all be worse for it. I'll see to the arrangements, my lord.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Take from the small folk? No!
Why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection.
Well, what were we supposed to do? Garrett just let
had
them
to go. I sent him away myself. I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
You had your reasons, but nonetheless, you undermined my authority. I can't have that happen again.
It won't, my lord. You have my word.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Where's the other dude? Oh, there he is. Malcolm. It's not the dude.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw Uncle what you Malcolm. Did today. It's not an easy thing to do, dealing out a harsh punishment, no matter how warranted. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him. To help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, but I'll be of no help to you in Essos. She insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
I must be firm. I'm not a boy anymore, and there is too much at stake.
The Lord's work can harden a man. It's true.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
People.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Okay. What's up, little sister?
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man.
Uh-oh.
The way you punished him? How could you
is
be
he
so
he saying
cruel?
That Duncan's as soft as a baby's belly? Ramsay dick twat.
I'm worried about you. What am I supposed to think?
I did what I had to, and I stand by it.
You talk like it was the only thing to be
it
done.
It seems all right.
I know you said you'd get angry sometimes, but I didn't think I'd see it so soon.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please.
Who should I name as my sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle. He's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Alright, I was going to go with the other guy, but I think I'm just going to give it to him. I'm not going to talk to the other dude.
Duncan, I've decided to name you as my sentinel. Congratulations.
Why, thank you, my lord. I'm honored. But are you sure?
Yes, of course. I'm convinced you're the man for the job.
Then I accept. But first, you must summon the small council, my lord, to make it official.
Right. I'll tell Maester Ortengren to do it at once.
No, you gotta have good cop, bad cop, Genie. And I plan on being bad cop, so...
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
Enter the tower. Who owns a dick so? Thank you, but are you sure? No. I said yes. I said I was sure. Welcome back, buddy. How goes it?
Marilyn's making cookies.
Slash and parry. Slash and parry. Again.
Okay, so we were up in the tower. Here we go.
Maester?
Maester?
Yes, Lord Ethan. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
All the people.
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
Okay. AH says he wants cookies. What was it?
Donation or win a contest.
Wow, that's so mean. Hi, AH.
What are you talking about?
No cookies for you, man, unless you donate or win a contest.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made
my
decision.
Or I could buy my own. That's true.
Or I could buy my own.
You could do that, but they wouldn't be MMs.
Who said that, AH?
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle? This is reckless.
Lord Ethan has made his choice. I will not disappoint you, my lord.
Now, Sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here. With no time
to waste. Oh my god, I can make some peanut butter cookies, yummy. Sounds
of.
Good.
We need to prepare for the worst.
There's no need to panic. We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You'd gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
It is the bloody small council.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not.
It's all the scars.
Take a cunning approach.
Yeah, he does
diplomacy
look.
Can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
Looks like he'd
the Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help.
Resting bitch
face. It's not
face.
Too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf. But we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah. The wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough! My new sentinel favors a certain approach and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made
Why
his
can't we be ready for a fight
you
too?
You will respect his decisions.
Hey, Candy. How is you? Welcome back.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Diplomacy with Ramsay, dumbass.
Well then,
whatever, Jamie.
We shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival.
This is not Jon Snow here.
Invite him into this hall and meet him face to face. Lord to Lord.
This guy's like 12.
No Lord? That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze.
We've already been told that we can't.
And when he enters,
we can't last more than a week in a siege.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle steering you wrong?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore.
Little dumbass,
Forgive
then.
Me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Not another word.
Your father would not approve, my lord.
I did not dismiss you, sir.
Apologies, my son. I had expected better of him. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
Uh-oh. This could be bad. We're letting the viper into the roost.
Leadership.
I did not excuse you from the dinner table.
You can rely on. Family.
Really?
Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a
Finish your
fighter.
Vegetables.
But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister.
Why would you bring him back after you exiled him?
He exiled himself. He has no desire to
I'd
rule.
Hide the sister and little brother, just saying. Might be smart.
Asher is volatile, but that is his strength, too.
If I were a lady in charge of a large house, it'd be so bad. Why is that, Katie?
I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that.
We don't need that. That's what we just... qualities.
But... I'm not like that. But I don't need to be, do I?
No. But you need someone who is standing beside you. I'm trying to do what's best for this family. What this family needs.
I declare war on anyone who gave me a dirty look or ate with an open mouth.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Alright, she's happy. Made Mom happy.
I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Yeah, we'll see about that. She's relying on Marjorie. Asher sounds like you start shit and get them all killed. Just about. This is chess, not checkers. Oh, it's the seal. Oh, we're gonna steal... Take them both.
I'm gonna turn the mixer on, okay?
All right. I want the seal.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you might want to know.
Steal all the things. Don't do it. Oh my god, you're making me nervous.
I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't
No,
hurt
what if someone friend. Sees?
We've known each other for years. It's a private matter. You shouldn't take it personally. Well, I did. I thought there was trust between us. Friends don't hold secrets from one another. Now Lady Marjorie thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion
very much. I don't trust
you,
douchebag.
Sarah, I...
Uh-oh.
My lady, I'll leave you to talk. Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for
no
your family.
No secrets? Okay, I just sold these things.
Gods. He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Understand,
cut off her pinky,
not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
No, don't notice the key. Do not notice the key.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira.
Don't hug me.
King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family, if you'll excuse me, my lady.
What's the key for?
Milady. Begging your pardon, milady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
I'm glad to see you.
Thank you, milady. I hope you saw. I was right
my
before.
Little
about
spy.
Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I could be useful to you.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... people who'd be willing to help you.
The big boy. Who is that supposed to be? It's not Mountain. It's not the Hound. Some nameless dude.
Where's Sir Roiland?
Up.
He should be here.
Run, jump ship.
Pride more than honor. We'll do without him.
And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men stand ready to act if needed.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
He appreciates your confidence. Where would you have the kids right there? Hide the babies.
A lovely pile of timber.
Oh no.
Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House
Why
Bolton?
Is Whitehill there? Fuck.
Son of Roosebolt.
Fuck this dude.
Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of
Thank
the
you,
Warden
Lord.
Of the...
That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
May I offer you bread and salt, Lord Ramsay?
I loathe.
Like how the guy looked right over right as Marilyn made the tapping
Aren't
noise.
Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily... impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill,
what a sick
can
prick.
Your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Look at that.
Oh no.
Poor Forrester.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton.
Sure, where is he?
Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you?
You bent the knee to a twat. No, I bent the knee for his father.
Well, on me.
You needn't worry. Your father will have what he needs.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust her, Forrester.
No, you can't.
They murdered our men.
I'm a
it
little
was
shit.
Forrester Squire.
Ramsay Snow, the best character
One
ever.
One soldier dead. One bolt.
Lord Whitehill is a liar. That's not how it happened.
Lad. A liar? He's a Whitehill. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord. hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our...
Unfollowed, disowned, blocked, and reported. Oh, no.
So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The White Hills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
No.
The Ironwood. But...
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the White Hills don't?
Yes.
We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down.
The White Hills had ironwood, once, but now those hills are bare.
Hence the name, of course.
They know nothing of how to cultivate the forest.
Look at their sigil, my lord. A barren hill.
Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point. We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's
no...
No. Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help
you
maintain
that,
the king's
like,
peace.
So overtly.
And make sure there's no
Game
more
of Thrones
trouble.
Glass.
This will cause nice. More trouble, not less.
Not for me.
And cookie dough.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We got cookie dough, boys. And a girl.
Anybody new here? Yoga?
You have a man you trust?
I'm not sure if this game's on Xbox
Griff.
One.
Riff.
And welcome.
You have no right. White Hills have no place here.
Lads, do make this.
What is going on?
Please, Duncan, don't.
What are you doing? Oh.
Being stupid.
Look at this little forester. You know.
Thank you, Marilyn.
You're welcome.
Cookie dough.
Get away from
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh.
Oh, we're twins. I didn't realize
like
that.
Like the queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the queen and her brother.
I mean, I can Google it for you.
Always wanted.
We have more to discuss, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well. I suppose you can stay.
Aren't Ramsay you? Snow just tried to take his sister.
Ethan! No!
Oh, shit!
No!
But I don't
he just killed me.
No. Far too much trouble.
Ethan! Ethan! No! No!
Even though he did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Lord Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
What have you done?
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him. They give you any trouble.
Brian! Fuck.
We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him.
Catch the mace!
He's killed like a 12-year-old.
You brought this on yourself.
Mother!
Stop!
Don't
let
him
go!
Let it go!
Stop that!
Help me! Ryan, please!
Stop it!
Ryan! Do something!
My son.
Oh, man.
Hide the babies.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
Okay.
This house needs a leader.
Oh, Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those
so I think that was going to happen anyway, right?
Other loyalties.
Oh, Jon Snow is going to be the next
stop
episode.
Until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home.
Tell
again,
you what had to go, Bysis.
Our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
You had one job.
Oh, man. I had one job.
He's being me too.
Nope. Not. 65% stay with Bowen, so I made the right decision there. 62% swore loyalty to the king. Only 16% took the Eric's fingers. Okay, fine, guys. Everyone liked Duncan. And it was split down the middle between meeting Ramsay at the gate or meeting him in the hall.